It's so good to be here this week, because last week I was working in Tennessee and coming here, and a route like this so you can drive. It's been 5 years since I've taken a job I couldn't drive because I'm afraid to fly. And when you admit that you're afraid to fly, people make fun of you. They say you're not sophisticated. Well, maybe I ain't. But damn it, I'm alive. I mean, you think about it, you're on an airplane, it's taking off, you look out the window, back down to the ground, the last thing you see is the word terminal. Now, let me say this to you. You know, for 5 years, I've been talking about my fear of flying. I hope after what's happened just recently, you'll listen to me. It hasn't been good. You know, this is real. You know, just 3-4 weeks ago, Northwest Airlines fired 3 pilots for being drunk. Drunk pilots. Damn. Now, how are you going to pull them over for DUI? You're like, well, who's going to go get them this time? I mean, by the way, the next time you fly Northwest, if you want to aggravate them, here's the way you can do it. When they come around to take your drink order, just say, I'll have whatever the pilots are having. They don't like that. Yeah, this is so bizarre, it sounds like a joke, but it really happened. Same airline at one of their major hubs in Memphis. A chunk of the wing, about 8 inches in diameter, just broke off and hit the ground. The FAA investigated and determined it was because there was a malfunction in the airplane toilet. This is true. Do you see what they're telling us? Somebody flushed the toilet and the wing fell off? Listen, you listen to me. The next time you're up there at 35,000 feet, you're sitting there, I don't think I can hold this any longer. Think a damn again. I don't care if you pee in your briefcase. And look, and recently, in the Carolinas, a plane was taxiing out on the runway and the engine fell off. Damn motor just fell off. It fell off. Dallas-Fort Worth, American Airlines plane had to land on the belly of the plane because the landing gear wouldn't come down. It was stuck. See, everything gets stuck before it falls off. Now, listen, this is true. Here's what they did. They put foam on the runway, and this airplane slid in. It slid in. Just don't sound right, does it? And you know what irritates me? For those passengers, when they get off the plane, to act like they were not afraid. Liars, liars, liars. They asked one guy, they said, are you frightened during this whole ordeal? He said, not really. Matter of fact, it was kind of fun. Because when the plane hit the ground, it made you swallow your stomach. Right. You know, and I know, that when that plane was 30,000 feet up, going 500 miles an hour, with 200 people on board, and the pilot came over the PA system and said, now look here, y'all. We ain't got no wheels. You know that guy wasn't up there going, oh, goody, goody. And look, and let's not forget Aloha Airlines. They're the ones that had that airplane that took off as a hard top, come back as a convertible. The top blew off. And the dumb things them people would say once they got off that plane. These are people who flew in and landed in an airplane that didn't have a top. It didn't have a damn top. One lady actually said this. She said, at first, I didn't even notice it. Yeah, I just reached out to push the stewardess button and the sun was in my eye. See, let me tell you people something. Everything they tell you about the safety of a plane is not designed to help you in an emergency. It's designed to make you feel better about being on the plane. Just like the oxygen mask. They say if we need it, it's going to pop down out of the ceiling. I ain't never seen it. I don't believe it's up there. Then they say if it does come down, for us to breathe first before we hand it to the person next to us. Well, hell, I was going to do that anyhow. I mean, I'm a pretty nice guy. I just can't see myself looking at somebody I don't even know and going, well, I don't have anything to live for. Why don't you breathe? let me tell you something. See, I am not an expert in aerodynamics. And I know you're sitting there going, nah. Well, but I'll tell you this, I've got a lot of common sense. And you can trust me on this. If you're ever up there at 30,000 feet and suddenly all those oxygen masks drop down, it's over. And to tell you the truth, if I just got a few seconds to live, I could think of something else I'd rather have in my face than that piece of plastic. See, I used to fly all the time, and I just learned my lesson. See, I was down around the Caribbean. If you get around the Caribbean, they got what they call a commuter plane, a little tiny, not like Delta's commuter. This is a plane that seats like four or five people, one propeller. They actually ask you how much you weigh. You know what I'm talking about. Listen, they said, how much do you weigh? I said, why do you need to know? They said, so we'll know how much fuel to put in. I said, fill it up. You idiot, fill it up. I weigh 600 pounds, fill it up. Look, wouldn't you hate to die in a plane crash cause some fat woman lied about the weight? And you know they do that too, you know, like, well, I'd rather die than know how much I weigh, you know. See, let me tell you something. I've been to Canada in a drove, went to Texas in a drove, been everywhere in a drove. And all these other comedians make fun of me, but see if this don't make sense to you. If you're going somewhere in your car and you're driving along and you hear like a thump underneath, you can go, damn, I wonder what that would. Listen, shh, listen. I believe it's that right back wheel. Listen, shh, shh, shh. That's great the way y'all did that. It's just like we was in a big old car. You know, some audiences won't fall for that, but hell, y'all did all right. So, you say, I better pull over here and see what that is. So you pull over side of the road, you'll get out, and you'll pee. Have you ever noticed this? Even if you didn't have to, if you stop beside the road, you'll just pee. So you look at it, you say, that muffler's loose. I'll get me a coat hanger and tie that sucker up. Now you're on your way. But if you're 30,000 feet up and you hear like a thump, you look out the window and see part of the wing floating away. No one's going to ask you for a coat hanger, I'll tell you that. You know, they had a crash in New York cost the guy to run out of gas. He run out of gas. He run out of gas. Remember the last year when the Delta pilot in Kentucky landed in the wrong town? Anybody remember this? He sure did. Supposed to land in Lexington, he set that sucker down in Frankfurt. He landed in the wrong damn town. A few hours later, they get this Einstein on the news. He said, well, I thought I was there. That's Delta, D-E-L-T-A. Don't even leave the airport. That's what I mean. See, everything they, listen, this is psychology. If I ever, you know what, I'll tell you something, Steve. You know what your relatives will do, kin people or friends? When they find out you're afraid to fly, here's what they'll tell you. They'll say, well, you know, more people die in car wrecks than they do plane crashes. I go, so? That's the way I want to go? Damn car wreck.